As we all know, the Samsung S23 Ultra can support 15W wireless charging. With the popularity of T2, Android phones will also support magnetic wireless charging in the future. For now, third-party accessories are required to achieve magnetic charging, such as this magnetic case. After wearing this case, it can be magnetically charged with the Apple MagSafe charger and other magnetic chargers. The wireless charger can be attached stably, and the phone won't fall down even if it is hung. With the case, the charging power is about 6W when charging with the Apple MagSafe charger. It can also reach about 3W to 9W when charging with other magnetic chargers. Due to the loss of magnetic charging, the power is lower when wearing the case. But if we use a traditional wireless charging stand, then the case will not affect the power. Next, we'll use the Apple MagSafe charger to fully charge it. The voltage is always around 9V, and the charging curve can be divided into two parts. At first, the peak power stays at 6.4 watts for 4 hours and 43 minutes. Then the power drops to almost zero quickly. It takes 4 hours and 56 minutes to be fully charged. From another curve, it can be charged to 50% in 2 hours and 26 minutes and 80% in 3 hours and 54 minutes. It also reaches 100% in 4 hours and 56 minutes. The charging speed is very slow. We also put them into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank throughout the temperature test. After 20 minutes of charging, the maximum temperature is 36.7 degrees Celsius. Since the power is only 6.4 watts at this time, the temperature is not too high. This is how to experience magnetic wireless charging with Samsung S23 Ultra. Most Android phones support higher power wireless charging but require proprietary chargers. Compared with traditional wireless charging, you can place the charger naturally to get a more stable attachment with magnetic accessories. But the loss of magnetic charging will slow down the charging speed. So if you're an Android user and want to get a better magnetic wireless charging experience, the T2 is the answer. Hopefully, more Android phones can support T2 very soon. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys next time. Bye!